Talk about hydrogen is everywhere these days. From airplanes to cars, it seems like everyone is boasting about how carbon-free hydrogen fuel will lower our emissions and slow down climate change. But if it were that easy, why are we still burning oil just to get to work? Well, it all has to do with the colors. So the reason hydrogen is such an appealing fossil fuel replacement is because when it is burned, the only waste product is water vapor. That's it. So much cleaner than fossil fuels. But to make matters trickier, there are several different ways to make hydrogen fuel, some of which don't actually do the climate any good. This is where the colors come in. They are labels to sum up how we made the hydrogen in the first place. Each method has their own pros and cons, so let's take a look at which colors will actually help stop climate change, and which ones are just greenwashing. First on our list are the not-so-colorful black, brown, and gray hydrogens. These are all lumped together because they all come from fossil fuels. Black and brown hydrogens come from a process known as gasification, using black and brown coal as the fuel. This reaction turns the coal into carbon dioxide and hydrogen gas. All the hydrogen is collected, and the carbon dioxide is just released into the atmosphere. Gray hydrogen is almost the same, except it uses natural gas in a process known as steam reforming. This reacts the methane with steam to generate hydrogen gas, just like gasification, while also releasing all the waste carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. So yeah, these three colors are just fossil fuels rebranded as clean burning hydrogen gas, and cause just as much damage to the climate as coal and gas do. Oh, did I mention they're also the cheapest and most popular forms of hydrogen on the market? But what about the alternatives? Our first real color is blue hydrogen. This is made the same way as gray hydrogen, but with one more crucial step. The carbon dioxide is captured at the end instead of being released into the air. In theory, this makes blue hydrogen carbon neutral, as the carbon emissions are all sequestered back underground. But even if we assume everything goes perfectly with sequestering the carbon, which is a big assumption, there will still be tons of methane emissions from leaky pipes and drills. Methane is a much, much stronger greenhouse gas than carbon dioxide, so maybe blue hydrogen isn't really the best for the climate either. A much more renewable option is green hydrogen. While our first four colors focused on using fossil fuels, there is another way to make hydrogen: hydrolysis. Coming from the ancient Greek words hydro, meaning water, and lysis, to unbind, it is literally that. An electric current runs through water, and the H2O unbinds into hydrogen and oxygen gas. It seems so elegant, taking one of the most abundant molecules on the planet and using it for fuel. Best of all, what makes green hydrogen green is that all the electricity used for hydrolysis comes from renewable sources, like wind, solar, and geothermal. This doesn't generate any carbon dioxide whatsoever, making this actually sustainable in the long term. Deep down, I know all hydrogen wishes it could be green hydrogen. However, we still have a couple more colors out there. Yellow hydrogen is one of the weird ones. Some people say yellow hydrogen is made via hydrolysis using whatever electricity the grid provides, making it far from carbon neutral. Others will say that yellow hydrogen is hydrogen that's made using specifically solar-powered electricity, which is really just the same thing as green hydrogen. I don't know, I guess some people just like the sun so much they thought it deserved its own color. The next color on the list is pink hydrogen. This is also generated from hydrolysis, but this time using nuclear energy as the source of electricity. While this may not be feasible with massive city powering nuclear plants, microreactors dedicated to just hydrogen production are definitely worth considering. Producing nuclear electricity generates no carbon dioxide, making pink hydrogen another potentially sustainable color. Oh, it also likes to go by purple and red hydrogen for some reason. People, please, can we just agree on one color? Finally, the last color on our list is turquoise hydrogen. This is a new type of hydrogen production called pyrolysis. This is where methane is heated in a container with no oxygen. This stops the methane from combusting, and instead it decomposes into solid black carbon and hydrogen gas. The coolest part about turquoise hydrogen is that sometimes the carbon will deposit in the form of carbon nanotubes. This could then be used in nanotechnology while also generating hydrogen fuel at the same time. However, this does still use natural gas as its main ingredient, meaning that this is not sustainable or carbon neutral. Still, it's a really fascinating method that is a much better alternative than gray hydrogen. Well, there you have it, the rainbow of hydrogens in all their glory. While all these colors of hydrogen will burn clean without releasing CO2 in the air, the way they are each made is far from equal. As the global demand for hydrogen grows, as countries try to meet their climate goals, it will be important to phase out gray and eventually blue hydrogen. These non-sustainable approaches to hydrogen production cannot continue to be marketed as renewable if they straight up come from fossil fuels. That being said, both green and pink hydrogen will have an important role to play in decarbonizing transportation and shifting our society towards long-term sustainability. Thanks for sticking around to the end. Leave a comment down below if you still have questions about hydrogen fuel or if you have a suggestion for a future video. As always, the links to all the sources are listed in the description. If you like this video, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to support Planet Zero. I'll see you next time.